أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Dear students, السلام عليكم Today we are going to discuss Shadab Zeest Hashmi as a poet. Dear students, Shadab Zeest Hashmi, another expatriate from Pakistan who migrated to America at a very early age of 19, and now she lives there, a teacher, a professor in a university, a columnist, a writer of prose, and a poet, a prominent poet of English language today. She has brought earned a good name for herself as an expatriate Pakistani. Although she has been living there, yet she has got deep roots in Pakistan, and her poetry reflects this very fact. This question about her poetry has been dealt herein with a different perspective, with all the critical views from Pakistani critics, English critics, and the American critics, and no commentary of our own has been included here, except here and there some tips for your examination point of view. As you know, two of her poems are included in our syllabi, therefore it is very much imperative for us to study her as a poet. This question will consist of two portions. This is the first portion, my dear students. Let's have a look at some of the contents. First, we will go through her personal life, only a few facts about her personal life, and then we will go on to some salient features of her poetry seen through the eyes of different critics. Please. Introduction. Shadab Zeest Hashmi was born on August 16, 1972, and now is an American poet of Pakistani origins. Her poetry, written in English, has been translated into Spanish and Urdu. Especially, she has been the editor of the Maggie Park Poets Anthology and Mahmag, and is a columnist for Three Quarks Daily. Many of Hashmi's poems explore feminism, history, and perspectives on Islam. Shadab grew up in Peshawar, Pakistan. She graduated from Reed College in 1995 and received her MFA from Warren Wilson College, America. Her poetry has appeared in many international magazines and journals. Shadab's essays on Eastern poetic forms, such as the Ghazal and Qasida, have been published in the Journal of Contemporary World Literature, and her essays have appeared in the Washington Post, Pakistaniyat, a Journal of Pakistan Studies, Nod Magazine, and Three Quarks Daily. In 10, Poetic Matrix Press published Shadab Zeest Hashmi's book, Bakar of Tarifa, which won the 2011 San Diego Book Award for Poetry. Her first collection was Bakar of Tarifa is a book of poems based on the history of Muslim Spain. It attempts to recreate a near millennium of Al-Andalusi culture, which transformed Western thought, values, art, science, and technology, building a legend of peaceful coexistence known as La Convivencia, Bakaya Bahmi, that is to say, Bakaya Bahmi ka wo jo pyara sa asool tha, jisko aap the Mosque of Cordova mein jaan chuke hain. The work looks at Muslim civilization as a bridge between antiquity and modernity, East and West, between three continents rather, Africa, Asia and Europe. And three religions, Judaism, Christianity and Islam, a golden chapter, not only in Muslim and European history, but human history as well. Shadabzist Hashmi has been inspired by the music of the Al-Andalus ensemble. ये कहा जाता है बेटे, और ये इसने खुद भी इसका इजहार किया है कि मैं जो है ना अल-अंदलुस को मैंने क्यों अपना जो है वो टारगेट किया। पहली चीज़ ये इकबाल से मुतासर हुई, खुसूसन इसने वो जो नज़म थी द मॉस्क ऑफ कॉर्डोबा वो पढ़ी, तो ये फिर खुद जो है वो वहाँ मॉस्क में गई, महसूस करने की कोशिश की उन फीलिंग्स को जो इकबाल ने क्रिएट की थी। लेकिन ज़ाहिर है वो इकबाल की स्पिरिट तो इस पर वो इसमें वो तो नहीं आ सकती, वो स्टेचर की शायरा नहीं है, लेकिन उनके फुल फुट स्टेप्स को फॉलो करने की कोशिश की और अंदलुस को जो है वो एक रिप्रेजेंटेटिव वर्क के तौर पर जो है उनके कल्चर को पेश करने की कोशिश की इसने अपनी इस कलेक्शन में, कलेक्शन ऑफ पोएम्स में। तो पहला तासर जो है वो इकबाल की तरफ से मिला एज अ पोएट। दूसरा तासर जो था वहाँ अमेरिका में, ये वहाँ एक ग्रुप ऑफ म्यूजिशियंस आया अल-अंदलुस से, जिन्होंने अपने वो रवायती जो उनके साज थे उनके साथ अल-अंदलुस का जो है वो म्यूज़िक जो है वो डिस्प्ले किया, तो उससे ये मुतासर हुई रूहानी तौर पर। शी वेंट टू स्पेन, विजिटेड द मॉस्क एंड ऑल कल्चरल हेरिटेज मोनूमेंट्स ऑफ द मुस्लिम्स, एंड फ्रॉम देयर ऑन शी वेंट टू कंपोज दीज पीसेज ऑफ पोएम्स। एलिनोर विल्नर कॉल्ड हाशमीज पोएम्स ल्यूमिनस। Shadab's latest book is Coal and Chalk, from where our two poems have been selected, Coal and Chalk, which uses themes from our own life as a naturalized American citizen, while also remembering her home in Pakistan. Dear students, as a poet, she has produced three works. Shadabzist Hashmi is the author of Ghazal, Cosmopolitan, Coal and Chalk and Bakar of Tarifa. बेटे ये तीन किताबें, ये गज़ल Cosmopolitan जो है ये essays का collection है, prose में है, और ग़ज़ल्स भी इसमें शामिल हैं, poetry भी है, और ये जो दूसरी collection है Coal and Chalk, ये खसूसन पाकिस्तान और पाकिस्तानी culture को represent करती हुई नज़में हैं, और ये जो बकर ऑफ तरीफा है इट इज़ अबाउट स्पेन एंड अल-अंदलुस। हर पोएम्स हैव बीन ट्रांसलेटेड इनटू स्पेनिश एंड उर्दू एज ऑलरेडी वी हैव डिस्कस्ड एंड पब्लिश्ड इन जर्नल्स एंड एंथोलॉजीज वर्ल्ड वाइड। हर एसेज ऑन ईस्टर्न पोएटिक फॉर्म्स सच एज द गज़ल एंड कसीदा हैव बीन पब्लिश्ड इन ऑल फेमस जर्नल्स एंड मैगजीन्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड। हाशमीज लेटेस्ट बुक गज़ल कॉस्मोपॉलिटन वाज showcased as the book of the month at San Diego Central Library. Her first book, Bakar of Tarifa, won the 2011 San Diego Book Award, already discussed poetry award. Apart from teaching, writing poetry is her main concern and interest living in America right now. My dear students, from here on in, we will discuss the poetry of the poetic talent of Shadabzist Hashmi from the angle and lens of different critical views presented by some Pakistani critics, practitioners of poetry rather themselves, and some Londoners, the English critics, and the recently some American critics as well. without commentary, you may use all these quotations and all these references in your questions about this poetess in your examination. three of our main books have been given above, Bakar of Tarifa, Coal and Chalk, and Ghazal Cosmopolitan. That is a compilation of essays. Rather, the first two are her books about the collection of poems. A marvelous interweaving of poetry, scholarship, literary criticism, and memoir. Marilyn Hacker, another poetess, Marilyn Hacker, says, शानदार इंटरव्यूइंग है पोइट्री की, स्कॉलरशिप की, लिटरेरी क्रिटिसिज्म की, और मेमोयर, और उसकी यादें हैं, वो यादें जो उसकी रूट्स, पाकिस्तानी रूट्स से बिलोंग करती हैं. अ गिफ्ट दैट एनरिचेज आवर लिटरेचर. छोटी सी एक देखें ये खूबसूरत सी व्यू, एलिनोर विल्नर. इसके आगे भी कुछ व्यूज़ हैं इनके, एलिनोर विल्नर के, लेकिन ये बहुत खूबसूरत इंटरप्रिटेशन है किसी शायर के बारे में. ये बड़ा अच्छा सा अप्रिसिएशन. ए गिफ्ट दैट एनरिचेज आवर लिटरेचर. एक ऐसा, इसकी शायरी एक ऐसा तोहफा है जो हमारे लिटरेचर में को इजाफा कर रहा है, उसमें एनरिच कर रहा है उसको. अ सेलिब्रेशन ऑफ एंड ए लव लेटर टू द लैंग्वेज ऑफ द वर्ल्ड, फैडी जुदा. ये हमारे फलस्तीनी शायरा, देखें ये भी कितना ज़बरदस्त किस्म की एक एप्रिसिएशन है. अज़रा रज़ा, अनदर क्रिटिक, एज आल्सो सेड अ वेरी स्मॉल पीस ऑफ क्रिटिकल व्यू अबाउट हर. A smorgasbord of aesthetic players viewed through the prism of the majestic ghazal. Azra Raza is also a practitioner of ghazal, English ghazal. A bridge between the Eastern and Western traditions of literature, Raza Rumi. He is also a practitioner of ghazal, belongs to Iran. I particularly like her emphasis on the ghazal's potential to adapt and her own ghazals. Marian Maltino from Africa. उसका जो गजल पर स्ट्रेस है मुझे वो पसंद है, और उसकी गजलें भी. तो माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, द नेक्स्ट opinion, critical opinion, is from very famous Muniza Shamsi, a short story writer, a poetess herself, and a critic of Pakistan. In her first collection, Bakar of Tarifa, a contemplation of a symbiotic Euro-Arab culture of Andalusia and its reverberations across the centuries, Shadab Zist Hashmi revealed a bold and original voice with an ability to meld cultures and poetic forms with great skill. In Coal and Chalk, she takes this further with her accomplished ghazals, a poetic form central to Urdu literature and song. This is a truly exciting collection, and Hashmi is clearly a poet to watch. Poet to watch, please. Dekhiye, ye zabardast kism ki praise hai. और बहुत अच्छी क्रिटिकल अप्रिसिएशन कही जा सकती है. बहुत शानदार अंदाज में उसकी दोनों किताबों को, जो है वो मेन जो बुक्स हैं उनको, कलेक्शंस को, दोनों को वो कवर किया गया है. इन ए कलेक्शन ऑफ एलिगेंट लिरिकल वॉइसेस, पाकिस्तानी अमेरिकन पोइट शदाब ज़ीस्त हाशमी आर्टिकुलेट्स हर प्रेयर फॉर इक्विनिमिटी, हर प्रेयर फॉर पीस. सांड्रा एलकोसा, another critic, she says that all her poetry is a prayer for peace. Indeed, dear students, another critical view about her poetry from Ibtisam Barakat, another practitioner of ghazals and qasidas. He is a Palestinian come African writer, powerful, courageous, gentle and entertaining at once. Very good praise about a poet. These poems carry the echoes of continents, different continents rather. You will see a staircase, each step in awe. You will dip your hands in henna and hesitate to leave the scent of green Goa. You will hear, listen, I am a paper kite in your hands, and for an instant become a child again on a windy day. And here is a necessary whisper as you read these magical poems. Whatever you do, be careful not to step on the iguana, the lizard, that sleeps along the entire length of the clothesline. Dear students, Elona Yusuf says about Ajmi that she draws a picture of the great flowering of ideas possible when a civilization is tolerant of diversity, and conversely, the withering and destruction brought on by war and literalism. Elona Yusuf herself is an expatriate Pakistani. Again, Eleanor Wilner's critical view has been discussed here in detail, although a hint was given in the beginning of this discussion. Al-Undalus, a unique cultural convergence in human time, where myth hovers the way moths are drawn to lampshine. Jaise moths jo hain wo roshni ki taraf lapkate hain, aise myths jo hain yahan wo aapko prominent dikhai deti hain. And in her luminous spare language, Hashmi catches its essence, utter of memory, the perfume of peace, sweet rising duff of dailiness, at the end smoke rising, the reek of war, useless keys, exile, sorrow distilled and deepened by the presence in these deeply felt, lovely poems of what feels newly lost. Eleanor Wilner. Sam Hamill, an English critic, says about these poems, her poetry, these ghosts, like fireflies, glow only for an instant. I have come to catch their light. Shadab's East Hashmi opens a door on the world of Islamic Spain, Al-Undalus, and through luminous anecdote, portrait and contemplation, reveals a world rich in history, rich in humanity. Sam Hamill. My dear students, this is a very, very beautiful description and critical view of the poetess presented by Morris Manning. The poems in Shadab's East Hashmi's fine collection offer spare and subdued reflections on the daily life, politics, art, and above all the cultural exchange steeping in the world of medieval Spain. Bakr of Tarifa ke bare mein ye yahan politics, art, ye sare themes jo hain daily life themes ko discuss kiya gaya hai. This book is informed by painstaking historical fact, to be sure, but the history here is illuminated by an imaginative fire. The poems are carefully conceived and finely crafted, notable for their supple phrasing and precise imagery. Bahut achhi tarah se isko evaluate kiya gaya hai, uski poetic talent ko. But a larger passion emerges from this collection, namely the reminder that there was a time when Muslims, Jews and Christians lived peacefully and decently together, and each tradition was made richer for it. Hashmi's Bakr of Tarifa is a somber, elegant and persuasive book. Dear students, Sam Hamill says again, these poems ring with clarity, restraint and humanity. My admiration for Shadab's East Hashmi's poetry continues to grow. Then Lisa Steinman says, capacious, crafted and lyrical, not just able to move from the domestic and the sensual to the political, but showing us the relationship between these. The poems in coal and chalk, to quote from notes for my husband weep in both languages. We are told in bilingual that a butcher selling tongues fills the speaker's greedy mouth with two half tongues. Although Farid's Shadabzi Hashmi is not a poet of half measures, but rather one who full-throatedly sings, as she puts it, the space between news and song. Dear students, it is the last critical view presented here by Claire Chambers. She is the editor of British Museum Fictions, a journal, a very famous magazine all over the world, in literary world indeed. She says, "Call and Shock is at once breathtaking and invigorating." काफी ताकतवर जुमला है और आगे बस उसकी यूं समझ लें कि इसी को आगे जो है वो उसने उसको एक्सपेंड किया है. द सेंसुअलिटी ऑफ आलमंड्स, कार्डामम, लेपिस लेजुली एंड चेंटिली लेस इज अंडरगर्डेड बाय ए जेनरस कॉस्मोपोलिटनिज्म. मुख्तलिफ ये वो जो मसाला जात हैं और वो जो ड्रेस डिज़ाइनिंग में इस्तेमाल होने वाले कलर्स हैं, ये लाजवर्दी रंग और वो लेस जो है खूबसूरत सी फ्रेंच, वो ये सारी कॉस्मोपोलिटनिज्म को शो करती हैं. ओबेद्स, गज़ल्स, विंडोज एंड कोलबाइन आर कनेक्टिव टिश्यू बाइंडिंग दिस पोएट टू द लेट ग्रेट कश्मीरी अमेरिकन पोएट आगा शाहिद अली. ये इसके टीचर भी हैं और बड़े क्लोज फ्रेंड भी थे आगा शाहिद अली, कश्मीरी शायर जो अमेरिका में सेटल हो गए. तो उन्होंने बहुत सी जो कश्मीरी शायरी की जो रवायात हैं उन्हें भी इसमें पोएट्री का हिस्सा बनाया. तो ये हमारी जो पोएटिस हैं मिस हाशमी, वो इनसे बहुत मुतासर हैं. येट हाशमीज बाइलिंगुअल वॉइस इज इंटायरली हर ओन, एकोइंग थ्रू द हिंदू कुश, लाहौर एंड एन अर्लियर पाकिस्तान ऑफ द जीना फैमिली, also taking in India, Afghanistan, Thailand, the US and Paris. In the words of the poet, my soul mercuries and lifts itself in the presence of such virtuosity in heart. Dear students, we may conclude that Shadabzi Hashmi is an expatriate living in America, but her themes of poetry are very much rooted in Pakistan and the Muslim history, especially Al-Andalus. She relishes in English ghazal and qasida, both foreign for English readers, but she is able to convey her feelings successfully. Her linkage to Pakistani culture is evident in all her poetry and prose. A very prominent writer now, a professor, a teacher, a commentator, a TV host, she is also performing as a TV host. She reads her poems herself on a television station, small television station in her own land where she is residing in America. Thank you very much, dear students, for participating in this brief discussion about Shadabzi Hashmi. The next session will also be about our poetry. Till then, it is Allah Hafiz and goodbye from my side. Thank you very much again.